Today's video is about amelogenesis. Please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. Before moving on to amelogenesis, let's highlight a few points of enamel. Amelogenesis or enamel formation begins at the bell stage of tooth development by the differentiated cells of the inner enamel epithelium called the ameloblasts. Once the ameloblasts form the enamel of the tooth, they become a part of the reduced enamel epithelium along with the stratum intermedium, the stellate reticulum, and the outer enamel epithelium. The reduced enamel epithelium later on engages with the oral epithelium, and finally the tooth erupts into the oral cavity, resulting in a loss of the reduced enamel epithelium with the ameloblast being a part of it. Which means that enamel cannot be reformed or reproduced once it's damaged by any stimulus, such as caries, because there will be no ameloblasts to reproduce it once it's damaged. And this is the reason that enamel is known as the hardest tissue of the human body, composed of 96% of inorganic material and only 4% of organic material and water. Hydroxyapatite crystals makes up its inorganic part, while proteins makes up its organic part. The proteins which makes up the organic part of enamel is of two main groups, called the amelogenins, accounting for 90% of its organic part, and the non-amelogenins, which accounts for only 10% of its organic part. Where the amelogenins are low molecular weight proteins, the non-amelogenins are high molecular weight proteins. Enamelin, ameloblastin, and tuftulin are the important proteins of this group. Enamel has a very complex structure. Its structure unit is made up of two components, the rod and interrod enamel. The outline of these two components resembles the shape of a keyhole and can be seen from the occlusal or incisal cross-section of a tooth only. Where the rod represents the head of the keyhole, the tail of the keyhole is represented by the interrod. To understand the orientation of rod and interrod enamel, we must first understand what amelogenesis is. Please watch my previous videos on developmental stages of the tooth to have a much clearer concept on today's topic. Amelogenesis is divided into three main functional stages: the presecretory, the secretory, and the maturation stage. In the presecretory stage, the ameloblasts prepare themselves to secrete the organic matrix of enamel and is further subdivided into two phases called the morphogenetic phase and the differentiation phase. In the secretory stage, the ameloblast secretes the enamel matrix and is further divided into three other phases called the initial secretory, the secretory, and the final secretory phase. In the maturation phase, the proteins present in the enamel matrix are degraded and are replaced by specific ions and minerals. This stage is also divided into two other phases called the transitional phase and the maturation proper phase. In the morphogenetic phase, the inner enamel epithelium assumes the shape of a crown. The cells of the inner enamel epithelium becomes cuboidal or short columnar in shape. The part of the cell facing the stratum intermedium is called its proximal portion, while the part of the cell facing its basement membrane is its distal portion. The nucleus of the cell is centrally placed. Mitochondria and other cellular organelles are scattered throughout the cell. A junctional complex is present at the proximal portion of the cells, and it's called proximal junctional complex. In the differentiation phase, as the name implies, the cells of the inner enamel epithelium is differentiated into ameloblasts. The cells become tall columnar and the nucleus of the cells shifts proximally towards the stratum intermedium. The Golgi complex increases in volume and shifts distally. Clusters of mitochondria are found surrounding the infranuclear compartment. A second junctional complex develops at the distal extremity of the cell. This distal junctional complex divides the ameloblast into a body and a distal extremity called Toombs process. The Toombs process is not fully developed at this stage. In the initial secretory phase of the secretory stage, ameloblasts are at the peak of its synthetic and secretory activity. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is formed at the supranuclear compartment of the cells, where they are readily available for translation of messenger RNAs of enamel proteins. The translated proteins are processed and packed into the membrane-bound vesicles through Golgi complex in the distal extremity of the cell, also called the Toombs process. But still, Toombs process is not yet fully developed here. And this is the reason that the first layer of enamel released at this phase would be structureless, or will have no rod and interrod enamel in it, because the rod and interrod enamel matrix will be released from the well-developed Toombs process only. In the secretory phase of the secretory stage, the ameloblasts migrates away and develops a distal portion of the Toombs process as an outgrowth of its proximal portion. In the previous two phases, which we discussed earlier, the ameloblast only had this proximal portion. The proximal portion of the Toombs process will form the interrod enamel, while the distal portion of the Toombs process will form the rod enamel. The proximal portion is the first one to lay down the enamel matrix, resulting in the formation of preformed cavities for the distal portion of the Toombs process to lay down the enamel matrix for the rod. Hence, the enamel matrix secreted at this phase will have both the rods and interrods in it. After the enamel has reached its maximum thickness, the ameloblasts become shorter and loses its distal portion of Toombs process. Ameloblasts now have the same overall appearance as when it was forming the initial layer of enamel. These cells now secrete the final layer of enamel, same as the initial layer of enamel, without any rods and interrods. At the end, the enamel will be composed of a rod and interrod containing layer, sandwiched between thin rodless initial and final layers. In the transitional phase of the maturation stage, the ameloblasts are reduced in height and volume, and 25% of ameloblasts will undergo apoptosis during this stage. In the maturation proper phase, the organic material and water of the enamel matrix is replaced by the inorganic material. And this is accomplished by a process called modulation. In modulation, the ameloblast shows cyclic alteration between ruffle-ended and smooth-ended ameloblasts facing the enamel matrix. The cell spends 80% of its time in the form of the ruffle-ended ameloblasts. The ruffle-ended ameloblasts have distal tight junctions and proximal leaky junctions, while smooth-ended ameloblast is completely opposite, having a leaky distal junction and a tight proximal junction. The ruffle-ended ameloblasts degrades enamel proteins by secreting certain proteases. Some of the degraded proteins are diffused into the leaky proximal junctions of the smooth-ended ameloblasts, and some of these are engulfed by the ruffle-ended ameloblasts by the process of endocytosis. The ruffle-ended ameloblasts alkalizes the acidic environment created by the degradation of proteins by pumping bicarbonate ions. It also pumps calcium ions into the enamel matrix and initiates the process of mineralization. If you think this video was helpful, please like, subscribe, share, and comment if you have any questions. Thank you for watching.